The sun allows us to enjoy pretty much everything we like in life. In fact, we wouldn't be here without it. But the sun can hurt us in ways beyond just a really bad sunburn.
Not surprising, considering it's a giant burning ball of hydrogen, helium, and more that is so big it contains 99.8% of mass in the entire solar system, with temperatures as hot as 27 million degrees Fahrenheit below its surface, that will one day engulf the Earth in its fire and bring death to the only planet humans have known. And oh yeah, NASA had to take all of that into consideration because they're going to it. Hey everybody, I'm Patrick Jones and welcome to Cheddar Explores. Today we're going to be talking about how NASA teamed up with the European Space Agency for two missions to study the sun. The missions are called Parker Solar Probe and Solar Orbiter, and their names hint at what they're tasked with. Parker will study the surface of the sun up close, and Solar Orbiter will take a wider look at the sun and its poles. Both missions have launch windows between July and October of 2018, and will use the gravity assist from Venus to reach the sun. The difference is they'll reach their desired orbits on vastly different timelines. However, both want to improve our understanding of the sun and the ways the sun could mess with us here on Earth. That's because the sun affects us in ways that aren't all apparently obvious. Of course, light, heat, and the gravity that keeps Earth and the solar system in place, but it goes further than that. First off, the sun has a protective shield around the solar system called the heliosphere. It's sort of complex, so I got some help from NASA to help me explain what the heliosphere is and why it's important.
So the heliosphere is a bubble that the sun has blown in interstellar space. Inside that bubble, we call the heliosphere, is particles coming from the sun and magnetic field from the sun.
But now things coming off the sun can be an issue for us for several reasons. The sun can dispel particles in a range of ways. That range goes from the heliosphere, which is the constant solar wind permeating our corner of the Milky Way, to mass ejections where huge bubbles of particles are ejected and flung outwards. And when these mass ejections come, and they will come again, it'll affect the good people of Earth in three ways. One, astronauts could get sick. This is for astronauts outside of Earth's magnetic field, but if we were to send people back to the moon or Mars, a solar flare could disrupt instruments and even cause radiation sickness. I can't conceivably think of a worse place to get sick than a small spacecraft heading away from Earth. The second and third reasons have to do with outages. These bursts can mess with satellites, knocking them out unless they're put in safe mode, and they can also cause power outages. And when you think closer about what a satellite being knocked out actually means, remember, satellites control GPS, so...
You can imagine airlines and boats, they need very precise navigation, especially airlines. You don't want a pilot to just have kind of an error bar of, you know, several kilometers. They need precise measurements.
I think we can all agree with that. And the thing is, these outages could last a while.
So if we have a really intense solar storm that hits us and causes widespread power outages, it takes a while to get those transformers back up. So it can create a lot of problems if it's really intense, and that's why we really want to be able to predict these things.
The Parker Solar Probe will be the closest craft we've ever sent towards the sun. Of course, that means it'll face blistering heat and radiation. We're talking 2,500 degrees Fahrenheit. In order to obtain actual measurements of the sun's surface, NASA needed to design a heat shield to protect the onboard instruments. Thanks to the heat shield, Parker's instruments will be able to operate under temperatures about 85 degrees. Parker's mission will span 7.5 years, launching in July or August of 2018, and it's gonna move really fast. It will get up to about 430,000 miles per hour. At that speed, you can go from Philly to DC in 1 second. From there, it'll get its first look at the sun in November of 2018. Solar Orbiter is gonna take a little longer, about 3.5 years to get to the sun and be placed in its orbit further out. Its mission is to look at the sun's poles and study how the sun rotates on its axis. Whereas Parker is gonna be closer, studying the more nuts and bolts processes. So good luck to NASA and the ESA while they study the sun, because the idea of being on a plane that suddenly doesn't know where it is because the sun is peppering the Earth with particles like a hot sneeze of fire is bad. In fact, it's just a nightmare. It's a nightmare. And I'm sweating. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please like, comment, subscribe. We're making a lot of fun stuff here at Cheddar, and we hope you keep watching.